Dr. Nick Delgado here, and I'm with Grant Corsi, and we're talking about an incredible breakthrough product called Cardio Glucose. Tell me about this product, and why are you so excited about the combination of berberine with alpha-lipoic acid and vitamin C?
So berberine, I'm a huge fan of, something I take every single day. I take this specific product, actually, every single day, Cardio Gluco. And what I like, as a gram of berberine, which is where all the clinical data looks at it, berberine's been studied against metformin, it's been studied in its effect on lipid values, on triglyceride levels as well, and it's shown to do a vast amount of things, whether it's lowering HBA1C on par with metformin, fasting plasma glucose on par with metformin, even triglycerides on par with metformin. And I like it. It's just a cardiometabolic foundation. And the beauty of it, it's a PCSK9 inhibitor, which is great. It also works well with alpha-lipoic acid because they're both master regulators of AMP kinase, which is an enzyme with our body. And when that turns on, insulin sensitivity increases, glucose uptake increases, triglyceride synthesis decreases, and is able to just help support normal triglyceride and cholesterol levels. So this is overall a great product, and the combination of both berberine and alpha-lipoic acid is essential for this.
Yeah, and I think it's well titled Cardio Glucose because it regulates glucose. It's beneficial to the heart. And all this conversation lately about a lot of anti-aging doctors saying, hey, why don't you take metformin? But then other doctors say, well, wait a minute, there's potential side effects with the prescription metformin. And yet with berberine, the literature is rich with benefits, as you mentioned, parallel to metformin without the side effects. So for me, it's the go-to. I know that when I started taking the product, as we age, and I'm no youngster, Grant, I know you're a former pro basketball player, and I don't know, you look like you might be in your 20s, I don't know.
Right there, smack dab in the 20s. I'm staying young as long as I can, Dr. Delgado.
I love it. But, you know, when you reach to the point where you're approaching 70 like I am, and I'm an active individual. I love to play athletics and, you know, continue to compete against the young guys like you. I can never hold my own on the basketball court. But let me take you into my sport, weightlifting, okay. Right? We'll have some fun. Yeah. But at the same time, I got to say, Grant, there's some really good books, including this book, The Alpha-Lipoic Acid Breakthrough. And Dr. Berkson, MD, PhD, forward by Dr. Julian Whitaker. I mean, he talks about the potential of alpha-lipoic itself. That's just one of the ingredients in this product to help to slow aging, repair liver damage, reduce the risk of cancer, heart disease, and diabetes. And of course, we can't make claims that it's going to truly, you know, fulfill that promise.
Sure.
But the science is good. And, you know, myself being the author of Blood Doesn't Lie, you know, I've delved deep into the subjects of health and anti-aging. Partly for personal reasons, because I want to stave and slow and reverse the aging process. But my clients that I work with, they turn to me and they say, what's the best product to take? And I got to say, Cardio Glucose is a must for basically anyone, say, past the age of 30. But if you take it and your diet isn't all that good, it makes sense, even if you're younger, right?
Yeah. I mean, it's something I take every single day. And it's a great product for the pre-diabetic patient, the person who has an elevated waist circumference, they already have high triglycerides, their cholesterol might be levels a bit out of range. But even somebody that's healthy that just wants to maintain those levels, this is a good product and something that should be used every single day to help with cardiovascular health, like you mentioned, with anti-aging. It's just a very broad spectrum product that I think could give benefit to every single patient.
And it's interesting because they talk about how alpha-lipoic acid is kind of absorbed high up in the system of the body. So it becomes a very effective natural antioxidant. And then combine that with berberine, there is a substance called mTOR, mammalian targeted on rapamycin. And as we age, particularly if we follow a diet that's too heavy in animal products, which the American diet and the Western diet is, we've seen that the berberine modulates or helps to calm down this overactive particular enzyme, as I mentioned, mTOR. And so we believe it's one of the reasons why an ingredient like this is being used so commonly for people who are pursuing longevity and anti-aging. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. I'm completely following. And you're right. There's doctors all around the nation that use berberine as a natural remedy where they don't want to give metformin. They know their patient maybe isn't on that side of the spectrum, and there's natural therapies that can work. And personally, I'm just a huge fan of berberine. I've been able to see it change lab values in my own life, which is great. I've been able to see it change lab values in my dad's life, which is awesome as well. And you see those personal stories, and you have them in your own life, you get convicted about a certain ingredient. And berberine is a great ingredient that's changed my life. So it's something I take every single day.
Well, there's a podcaster that's a Harvard professor, and he wrote a book, and he's getting a lot of press, and he's talking about, you know, using the equivalent of as I mentioned, metformin to slow and reverse the aging process. Mm-hmm. However, I don't buy into that. I think Dr. Jonathan Wright, MD, who's written books and has been reviewing the science on hormone and biology and anti-aging, he himself prefers not to take metformin. He takes berberine. And he takes it at the dose you mentioned that's found in cardioglucose. So I would go with the world experts and not the young professor that, you know, wait till he reaches my age and Dr. Jonathan Wright's age. Let's see how he ages, how he fares. His diet isn't as good as I would say. He drinks coffee. He has some other habits that, honestly, I don't agree with. And you get a lot of press because you're a Harvard professor and sure. He's well-spoken. And he's still young and he looks young. But time will tell, and we'll see. I'm not here bashing him. I think he's a great guy. I didn't mention his name, or maybe I should. But the reality is that we're getting information out there. And he, like many doctors and scientists and researchers, are always looking for what is the natural equivalent. And don't get me wrong. We need a healthy diet, which we would agree is rich in more plant-based whole foods, exercise, power of the mind, sleep. And you really need to look at taking cardioglucose for the advent of alpha-lipoic acid, berberine, and really at effective dosages, along with the vitamin C that supports the absorption of these vital ingredients.